Merhaba, teacher.
Professor Haki, just a second. I have a comment trying to make that generally from a chair, there come certain popular kinds of statements. But I believe that when we are in conferences and seminars, we have to be very critical of things. We should never be influenced by anything which is a populistic version of things. Please reflect. What is your creation about the topic you have chosen? And if it is done, then you will definitely present it in 5 minutes. And we will appreciate it. Please, all the speakers, take the time of 5 minutes so that we have some time for discussion. Yeah. Professor Khaki.
Dr. Mazhar Hussain, my revered teacher, Dr. Abdul Ghani, Honorable Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Manzoor Alam, almost a household name in Kashmir, especially in University of Delhi, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I am Jain Khaki from the discipline of Islam studies, working in the Center of Central Asian Studies, University of Kashmir, as an associate professor. I am highly grateful to the organizers of the seminar who have provided me an opportunity to be a part of this event. So before taking much of the time on the introductory part of the session, my present topic will be cultural interaction between Central Asia and India, studying the role of Islam. The concept of cultural interaction has become an advanced discourse of academic activity in the contemporary world. Appreciating and evaluating all discussions and conjectures about cultural interaction and also giving a due space to the meanings and explanations that are being assigned to this concept, the present paper is an attempt to discover the roots and origins of cultural interaction, both as a concept and as a process in the early Islamic period. Most of the features of the current wave of interconnectedness and cultural interaction owe its origin to the pluralism and encouragement of Holy Quran, much of scholars in the far off lands, dissemination of knowledge and learning, translation movement and the concept of pluralism and coercion, some of the features essentially with Islamic orientation which encourage cultural interaction at doctrine and practical levels. The paper as such will seek out the impact of all such factors on the mode of cultural interaction that has got roots in the civilization of Islam. The study of history reveals many parallels in different regions of the world, particularly between the places interlinked due to geographical proximity and the common cultural heritage. Similar trends in literary and artistic activities in India and Central Asia were reinforced through the exchange of ideas. Significant contributions were made by Central Asian Iranians and Indian scholars and other artists to the enrichment of Asian culture and civilization. The study essentially an endeavor to identify the quantum of relationship that existed between the grand regions of the world and to refer to the implications of the process of cultural interaction to ascertain the Islamic future of the newly born independent states of Central Asia. Although many scholars have identified cultural interaction as an advanced phenomenon of 20th century, more commonly characterized as a byproduct of the collapse of the Soviet Union, the concept is fundamentally rooted in the remote past, owing its origin to varying factors involved in the Islamic period. One of the characteristic features of cultural interaction in the modern age has been expanding commerce between countries, extensive interaction between different civilizations and societies, as well as travel over vast distances across regions of the world. The roots of this phenomenon reach far back in history. The conquest of multiple territories, intermixing of races and synthesis of various cultures demonstrate the global vision of Islam. The international trade network that was initiated in the early centuries of Islam turn the whole world into a single trading network of connectivity. For instance, the audience gathering will be surprised to know that the boatmen of Bosphorus in Ottoman Empire were paid token that could be cashed from the banks around the river Oxus. This speaks of the process of cultural interaction connectedness that has already got roots in the civilization of Islam. The historic Silk Road network in this connection connected almost all trading routes leading to Europe via Central Asia during medieval period. Notwithstanding the significance of trade, the Great International Highway was instrumental in transformation of ideas and influences, leading thereby to transcultural dialogue. global context and human integration. The Karakoram Highway from Sawak onward to Gilgit, Hunza, Kashgar and Yarkat is littered with thousands of inscriptions carved on the rocks in Sanskrit, Sogdian, Chinese, Tibetan and other languages that speak of the movement of mission, that speak of the movement of the missionaries, tradesmen and other people from China, Central Asia and South Asia. In fact, I had an opportunity to visit the route from Srinagar to Kargil to Leh, then Chishur to Neoma, long distance reaching at the end to the Chinese borders, while I have myself seen most of the big rocks, while they have been engraved many statements by Arabian tradesmen, by most of the scholars, thereby depicting the fact that this was the route, in fact, that was used by the most of the scholars to have their interconnectedness with the rest of the world and the rest of the community. The links of Arabs with Central Asia, the spread of Islam and subsequent consolidation in the region are by and large connected with this grand city route. In developing the cultural links between India and Central Asia, Buddhism at the very outset became a binding force between the two regions. However, with the coming of Islam in the Central Asia, Islam in South Asia was further enriched by Central Asian scholars and the Sufi saints began to pour in the region. The Sufis therefore played a significant role the way as the Buddhist monks played in the expansion of their own ideology. In fact, many of the features of the current wave of cultural interaction are acknowledged, encouraged and persuaded by the specific directions of the religion. The Quran stresses on the need of historical knowledge as a moral exhortation to the faithful when it says, have they not traveled in the land to see the nature of the consequence for those who disbelieved before them? To travel on the earth has been, in fact, formally, initially, as a moral, to be studied as a moral lesson for the general communities, but it has been explained by as a substitute for a formal study of history. Mutrabi, a 7th century Central Asian poet, is reported to have said that one must behave like a pawn in a game of chess, whose ascent is possible only through continuous traveling. The assessment of the scholar represents the typical view of a medieval man who is fond of traveling and interaction with the rest of the community. Celebrated scholars of Central Asia, as a result of this, began to travel far uplands for trade and acquisition of knowledge. Khorasani merchants acquired rare books from most parts of the globe, and Central Asian Sufis established their silsilas in different parts of the world. Renowned works like Chahar Makalabai Nizam Urzi Samarkandi, Sikandar Nama of Nizami Ghanjvi, Fatuhul Buldan of Yaqut al-Hamidi, and Safarnama of Ibn Fadlan, besides providing a descriptive sketch of socio-cultural conditions of medieval Central Asia, refer to the quantum of relationship between India and Central Asia. Ziauddin Burmese